Praise be to Jesus Christ, dear children. Today we will learn chapter 15, Heaven, the House of God. First of all, let us begin our class with a small prayer. Because prayer is like talking to God. We are inviting God to come to us during this class and asking Him for His blessings. Children, now join your hands and repeat after me. O Lord, thank you for this wonderful new day and for blessing us throughout the week. Be with us during this class and help us to understand what is being taught to us. Amen. Now, let us recap what we learned in our last class. We learned that Jesus used to pray daily to God the Father. He taught His disciples to pray. We saw that on one such occasion, the disciples came to Jesus and told Him, "Lord, teach us to pray." Then Jesus answered, "When you pray, say, 'Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.'" Jesus taught His disciples the perfect prayer, the Our Father prayer. Jesus asks us also to pray. We can pray in whatever position we like to pray. Stand, kneel, or bow our heads, or close our eyes while praying. You should pray daily during important events. You can pray when you get up in the morning as well as when you go to sleep in the night. We saw in the last class, Jesus said that you should always have a conversation with God whenever you pray. Talking to God reminds us that He is in control. He loves us and He wants to be close to us. It's all part of us having a relationship with Him. I am sure you all have prayed to Jesus, praising Him and thanking Him for everything that He has blessed you with. We also heard the story of Nehemiah, who was a worshipper of God and who worked in the palace of Persian king Artaxerxes. Well done, children! Amazing! Now, did you memorize the beautiful Bible verse we learned last week? Rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer. From Romans chapter 12, verse 12. I am sure you all did so. Very good, children. Let's now learn about heaven, the house of God. Children, you all must have heard this wonderful song on God's love. You can all join with me in singing. Are you all ready? Let's sing. God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. Oh, wonderful love. It's so high, you can't get over it. So deep, you can't get under it. So wide, you can't get around it. Oh, wonderful love. Very good, children. You were really awesome with your actions. Isn't this a wonderful song on God's love? This beautiful song shows the greatness of God. And have y'all wondered about God's greatness? Let's see. Yes, God's greatness can be seen in His creation and the beautiful world that we are living in. God created us and has given us such a beautiful life. I hope you all remember the lessons we have learned earlier on His creation. The beautiful world that He created for us and how He created all this for us. You know, children, God is constantly showering us with His love. God is love, and His love is beyond any measure. Now, children, have y'all ever thought why God loves us? Yes, God loves us because He is love itself. He created us to have a loving relationship with Him. And can y'all think what else God did for us? Correct, my dear children. God gave us Jesus, His only Son. And can y'all tell me how Jesus showed His love for us? Jesus died on the cross for us, and His death on the cross was the greatest act of love that the world ever knew. We have seen earlier that Jesus was obedient to His Heavenly Father, always listening to Him. You know, children, Jesus leads us to heaven and He helps us to be with God in heaven. Our aim must always be to reach heaven. God dwells in heaven. We must always do good deeds, so God will be happy with us and we can also reach heaven. Let's listen a little on heaven. Are you all excited? The last book of the Bible, Revelation, tells us how wonderful heaven is. Although God is everywhere, His throne is in heaven. There are angels and other heavenly beings there, and they all worship God in heaven. And also, all God's people who have died and gone to heaven also worship God. They sing special songs of praise to God there. The last pages of the Bible describe heaven as the New Jerusalem, and it is very, very big with a high wall outside. The wall is of jasper stone, clear as crystal. Jewels and precious stones cover the foundation of the wall, sparkling with gorgeous colors. Each of the city gates are made of a single huge pearl. Wow! Isn't this so amazing and so wonderful? Let's listen more on how beautiful heaven is. Now, these pearly gates are never closed, and from inside heaven is even more beautiful. The city is made of pure gold, like clear glass. Even the street is made of gold. A beautiful, clear river of the water of life flows from God's throne. On either sides of the river is the tree of life, which was first found in the Garden of Eden. This tree is very special as it bears 12 different kinds of fruit, a different kind each month. The leaves of the tree of life are for the healing of the nations. Children, you know, in heaven, there is no need for the sun or the moon for light. God's own glory fills it with wonderful light. There is never any night there. Wow, so amazing! Now, like here on earth, there are no angry words heard there, and there is no fighting. Everything is peaceful in heaven. There are no locks on the doors because there are no thieves in heaven. There are no liars or any wicked people there. There is no sin of any kind in heaven. You know, children, sometimes people cry here on earth because of great sorrows in their life. But in heaven with God, there are no more tears. God wipes away all their tears. There is no pain, no sickness in heaven. Everyone there is happy forever with God. So, children, we must all long for this wonderful life with God. Okay, children, now let us learn a Bible verse for the day. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. From Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 2. You can tell your papa and mama that you have learned a new Bible verse today. Okay, children, that brings us to the end of this class. Let us conclude today's class with a small prayer. Oh God, bless me to be with you always in heaven. Amen. So, dear children, we will meet again next week to learn more on this exciting chapter. Till then, keep smiling because Jesus loves you. See you next week, dear children.